few scriptures and then I'm just going to speak and just share a few thoughts with you. Is that fine? Yes. I'm going to stray away from the theological point sermon. Hope Daniel doesn't kill me. Since he's very inspired by my black suit, as I can see. Let's take it off. I was listening to a song by a youth from our church. He's one of his artists in the song. It was very interesting. The chorus said something like, "There ain't nobody." That was the English. "There ain't nobody preaching true gospel. All I hear is save and save and that, miracle this, miracle that." So I asked myself, what then is the gospel? The gospel is the good news, am I right? And the good news of who? Now, let's go to Mark 16, verse 20. There's something very amazing that I saw there. Mark 16, verse 20. I read from the New King James Version. "Then the disciples," or sorry, from the NIV, "then the disciples went out and preached everywhere, and the Lord worked with them and confirmed his word by the signs that accompanied it." When they preached the true gospel, God accompanied it, or he confirmed it, if you read in the book of Acts, by signs, wonders, and
miracles.
So you might ask, why day of miracles? Why not day of miracles? Our generation has a desperate need to witness genuine, and I mean genuine, divine miracles. There are many people being deceived today by counterfeit miracles and all those spiritism and all those, but that's not what I'm here to talk about. I'm here to talk about what the gospel and genuine miracles. Now, it's a place where we've come to learn. So that when we go out, we can be workers of miracles. And how do we become workers of miracles? By simply preaching and living the true, uncompromised gospel. Point number one. Point number one. Reading and preaching the Bible. The Bible is God's divine revelation to man. As we read the Word of God, we are inspired and challenged by it. We are inspired, we are challenged by the divine miracles and all that God has done. And he says that he will do again. The divine inspired Word of God can create an attitude in every heart for miracles, making it a fertile soil in which God can perform the supernatural. When Jesus was with the disciples, he gave a parable, and he gives a parable of the sower. And he said, the words that I speak are like, they are like seeds, right? That are thrown on different types of ground. Your part is to make sure that your ground is fertile. Is your heart fertile? When the word of God comes, harden not your hearts. There are many people who want to move in miracles, signs, and wonders, and yet do not want to devote themselves to prayer, to reading of the word, to living holy lives. The church is in a state where it is broken, powerless, and weak. Because the very people in the church are not being the church. I made a statement with Ben and I said, the devil has no problem with you going to church. Trust me, he has no problem with it. He has a problem when you become the church. Because the people coming into the church are going out the same. They are not being transformed. They are not the church. They are not the bride of Christ. They are not living the word. Why? Because some don't know it. Some are ignorant. Some are simply arrogant. They know it's not supposed to be there, but they don't do it. So on a day of miracles, I may bring us back to simply some of the basics. Prayer. It has been said by some people that God does nothing except in answer to prayer. As one reads the word of God, there is something you will find that is common in each and every one. Men who worked miracles were men of prayer. So, and the apostles, Acts chapter 3, when it says, and or is it 2 or 3 when it says, and they devoted themselves to the teaching, to prayer, breaking of bread, which is what we practically do.
We have prayers, we have concerts. Amen. We love this stuff.
Brian, youth meetings, packed. Prayer meeting, full. Acts 4:24. Says they lifted up their voice to God with one accord. And then Acts 4:31 gives the result of what happened. And when they prayed, the place was shaken where they had assembled together, and they were all filled with the Holy Ghost, and they spoke the word of God with boldness. And when they spoke it with boldness, it says many miracle signs and wonders were worked through the hands of the apostles, and many were added to their number daily. Someone came and asked me, how is it that you attract so many people to an empowerment? I said, I don't know. Maybe because you preach the word. Could it be that? I don't think we've had a concept of it. We're not against concepts. We love concepts. I'm going to sing on myself. Obedience is also key. If you want to represent the miracles, obedience to the word. Now let's look at someone who was expecting a miracle, okay? And he went to a genuine man of God. Very, if it was these days, people would call him proud and very rude. Because the man came from Kasam, was a general there. Came leprosy and knocked on Olympia. Hello, I need healing. I've been told there's a man here that heals. Without even saying nothing, he says, kneel and out, and he says, go and tell him to wash in the river Olympia. So he walks out, and the man complains. And this is one thing that I've noticed in the attitude of men. Believers in the church. His response was that there are many rivers where I've come from, even better. But then this was the army person was with him who told him, sir, if he had told you to do something exceedingly difficult, you would have done it. If we had told you fast for 40 days, then you begin moving miracles. We would all be on a 40-day fast.
I mean, would always be fasting until I look like me, very not big. But because it's something that comes by obedience, you seem to have a problem with it because you want something that you can work towards. We want to be able to say, when we walk in front of you, say, okay, listen, I came from a 40-day fast and the Lord was speaking to me. And I was seeing angels coming. And they were saying to me, these are mantles that I am bringing. You will move like a light. This is what we want. We don't want to preach the uncompromising gospel that says, this is sin, this is not. Pray or not. You as a believer are supposed to pray. You as a believer are supposed to live a life such as this and this and this. We want maybe some overly complicated theories, theological terms, maybe that's when we're going to get it, when it's pretty plain and simple. When they pray, they will be the Holy Ghost, they preach the gospel and God confirm it with signs and wonders. Simple. Every place you will find where there are miracles being worked, you will find people preach the word. Many people have not experienced the fullness of the Holy Spirit in relationship with Him in their lives because of disobedience. I have noticed this in the people that I have interacted with. I noticed this in myself where, wow, thank God that disobedience is wrong. Because you will be busy and you will say, get on your knees and pray. Just like that. My name is losing. I need to intercede.
Okay,
Acts 5:32 says, let's just go there. I'm going to stay in Acts for a while. Oh my God, 4 minutes. Jesus. Before my miracle stop time. The day the sun stood still. So I was patient. We are witnesses of these things, and so is the Holy Spirit. Who God has given to those who obey Him. We are witnesses of these things, and so is the Holy Spirit. Who God has given to those who are in obedience. Many people want things that God knows when they get will destroy them, because their lives of disobedience. With that, forgive me, immoral music, with that very beautiful lady that visits you when mom's at home, you want to move in miracles, signs and wonders? If you want a miracle, if you want to move a miracle, simply one thing is also needed. We came from a faith revolution, we need faith, you need to believe. Let me see you through. Abraham was old, so was his wife. The Bible says the way of the point of death, if you read it in Hebrews. He was as good as dead. As a man, he was as good as dead, meaning he had gone to doctors, he had flown to Morningside in South Africa, they told him, no, sorry, nothing. God came and told him, Sarah laughed. God, please. And Hebrews 11:11 says, through faith, Sarah herself perceived strength to conceive seed, and was delivered of a child when she was past age, because she judged him faithful who had promised. Are you judging God faithful for what He has promised you in your life? And are you where you are? Because if I tell you, meet me at DK at 10 hours on such and such a day, and I will give you this. If you don't show up, Will you get what I was supposed to give you? Some people want, we agreed for 10, others want to come at 14. When I am in the right place, but I'm coming at a time where it's more convenient for me. Well, you see, God, me living in such a way is not so good because my friends are not going to like me that much. Well, you see, I can't get on my knees in the church to pray. Well, I'm the director at my church, so God love. Lastly, then I'll stop. I hope. You must make a date for your miracle. This is if you want to receive a miracle. You believe, right? You must make a date for it. You must tell God, I want a miracle. The woman with an issue of blood, the Bible says she said this to herself. If I may but touch his garment, I will be whole. I will be healed. What declaration of faith have you made? What declarations of faith do you make when going into your prayer time? Into your personal time with God? What personal declarations do you make when you're going for that prayer meeting? When you're coming to this conference? What did you say I am expecting from God? I know that if I go to this place, my life will not be the same. A people who move in miracles are people of God. And people of God are a people of the Word. A people devoted to prayer. Let's just get to a few. Based on the fact that Wigglesworth moved like this, so I must move like this. Wigglesworth said this and then this happened. So I also slap people who have cancer. Okay. It must be based upon the Word of God. Simple. What does the Word of God say? And lastly, we need to be for you to be a person of miracles, what you see expands. Jesus understood the value and power of the testimony in preparing the hearts of the people who experienced the miracle working power of God. When Peter and John witnessed the supernatural, they said in Acts 20, we cannot help but speak of the things we have seen and heard. You will find people who move in miracles are people that have exposed themselves to testimonies of the miraculous. There are people who spend hours upon hours watching people who've gone before. People who have great testimonies. Why? So that their faith might be challenged and stretched. They don't sit and watch Telemundo. They don't feel the passion. There are people who have said, I have made a covenant with my eyes, yes, to look upon the greatness of God and to be challenged by it and to move in it daily. Amen. Just raise your hand. Father, I thank you for these, your great souls that you have assembled in this place. Father, I ask that you bring an awakening within them, a hunger a hunger for your word, a hunger to see your greatness manifested in the dead churches, in the dead homes. That as though we are as Sarah in situations that are dead, we believe in faith and we need the Son to be brought forth. Father, I thank you for these hands that are lifted. I thank you for your sons and your daughters. I thank you that your miracle-working power is working within them and through them. I thank you that they are great testimonies of your word. I thank you that they are testimonies of your goodness, your grace, your mercy, your power. Father, I thank you that you are who you are. Now that as hands are lifted, Jehovah God, you are setting forth a fire within them. You are setting forth a fire that cannot be quenched. A fire like Jeremiah when you wanted to be silent, could not be contained, and he said it was like a fire burning in my bones. Father, I thank you that you are aligning them. That you are placing them with those that are right. A people that will shine. That you are setting them in the right environment. That there is divine revelation and understanding of your word and the manifestation of it. In the mighty name of Jesus, I have prayed. Amen.
Amen.